Many real-life situations involve growth and decay. They involve an increase or decrease of a value as time passes by. Population numbers, world temperature patterns, and the value of money are examples of values that may increase or decrease over time. Remember, values can be displayed as fractions, decimals, or percentages. Before we look at growth and decay, also known as percentage changes, we must firstly become familiar with calculating percentages. If we invest £1,000 in a company, the success of our investment is determined by a profit or loss. Has our £1,000 increased or decreased in value each year? Firstly, we must be able to work out percentages. Let's have a go. The normal price of a TV is reduced by 40% in a sale. The sale price is £300. What is the normal price? Remember, £300 is 60% of the original value. You could divide 300 by 60 to give 1%, then times by 100 to get the full amount. The original price is £500. This is the price of a motorbike with 20% VAT value added tax. What would the price be before VAT? Rearranging the formula will help with this equation. £6,240 divided by 1.2 equals £5,200. Percentage changes often happen over time, and depreciation is an example of exponential decay. The value of our cars depreciate each year. If John buys a car worth £15,000 and it depreciates at a rate of 10% every year, what is its value after 3 years? The car depreciates by 10% of its current value at each point in time, not of the original value. To do this, we must find 10% of the new value each year. After the first year, the value of the car is £13,500. At the end of the second, it's down to £12,150. By the end of the third year, it's come down to £10,935. This is depreciation and is an example of exponential decay. Remember to be careful here. This is commonly calculated incorrectly. 10% of 15,000 equals 1,500. And a common mistake is to multiply by the number of years, which gives £4,500 to take away from the original value. This is not correct, and we must remember to calculate 10% of the current value, not the original value. £10,500 is different to the £10,935 seen before. Remember, cars will always have some value, even if it's just for the material scrap value. Can you work out the difference using the two examples after 10 years? Our savings may increase simply due to the interest earned. Compound interest is an everyday example of repeated percentage change, which grows exponentially. The amount paid in interest is added to the balance of the account. The next time interest is calculated, the balance will be higher. This is an example of exponential growth. Interest is earned on the total amount in an account at any time, not just the initial amount. £3,000 is invested in a bank for 3 years at a rate of 5% interest per annum. To work out the total interest, we need to follow these steps. 100% plus 5% gives us the multiplier 1.05. This is the situation after 1 year, and after 2 years we get this. At the end of the third year, the total is 3,472.875. The change over 3 years can be represented in an equation. You can think of exponential change like this. A ball is dropped from a height of 9 meters. Every time it bounces, it rises to 90% of its previous height. How many times does it bounce before the height is less than 5 meters? Here's the height after the first bounce, then after the second, and the third. Look! The height's finally fallen to below 5 meters. So the answer is 6 times. As before, we can express this by an equation. Well done, you've followed all our examples. Now, why not try out what you've learnt in this video and have a go at some exponential growth and decay problems?